Hey guys, welcome back to Bookworm Brie. So, you guys know what's happening because you clicked the video due to the title. I'm gonna be reading these books and vlogging. It's motivation to read the books because I'm kind of stuck on these. I haven't even opened it and I'm already like... So yeah, this is my motivation. I hope you guys enjoy. And we really don't know how long this is gonna take. This could be like definitely not one night because it's a Saturday and I have church tomorrow. But this could be like a 3-day thing or like a 2-week thing or even like a 3-month thing. So enjoy. Okay, so it is April 1st and it's 3:15 and I just finished making a Bookworm Brie video. So my room is kind of messy. So I'm probably gonna clean that up a little bit and then do a couple things on Instagram. And then yeah, then I'll sit down to read this. Okay, we're back. It is 5:00. I just wasted an hour and 45 minutes. I made a birthday post. Didn't clean my room, but went through a bunch of old photos. So now I'm gonna start reading. Here we go. Okay, so far I'm like really vibing with this book. Like it's actually pretty good. And like lately I've been like kind of tired of dystopian because they're kind of like the same like 5 things over and over again. But this one's like actually pretty good. And I was expecting this to be more cheesier. Don't ask why, but like, I don't know. It just kind of gives like books that are targeted towards 8-year-olds. Literally don't ask. That's just the vibes I got from these books. So yeah. Anyway, it's pretty good so far. And I like the way that she changes the font for each character. Makes it easier to read and easier to like keep up with who's who. I really like it so far, actually. And I'm only on page 45. Okay, maybe I'm just slow, but is this an enemies to lovers? See, I literally know nothing. I just, like, when I first found BookTok in, it was 2021. And I just like saw a book. And everybody was like, read this book. And I was just screenshot. Like I literally, most of my camera roll, you can tell when I found BookTok because it just endless screenshots and just like YouTube videos that I saw with people like, read this book. And then this was on the list. I'm really liking this so far. So that's good. Like I was gonna take a break at 50 pages. I'm on page 50 now. And I'm definitely gonna take a break at 100. So yeah. Okay, I probably am just really stupid, but is that Matthias? Like the name? That's such a weird name to say that. Like a weird way to say it. I'm kind of puzzled. Also, I'm sorry, but Matthias, whatever his name is, Matthias's nickname for Junebug. Why do young adult books do that? Like, why is it like the most randomest things like that? Like Junebug. Like, that doesn't even sound like a nickname. Hello, good morning everyone, I guess. It's 2:45. Got back from church, happy Palm Sunday. I'm probably gonna read for like 30 minutes before I clean up my room because I normally have Sunday be like my reset day and all that stuff, so yeah. Guys, the part where they meet, that was really clever on the author's part. So good for them. Guys, this is nasty. The boy shifts his eyes away. I release a breath. I realize that I'd been holding it in while his eyes kept me frozen in place. Ew. So there's a part where she's in the alley and so I'm just gonna read like little snippets of it. Goes, then he crouches down behind it, motions for Tess and me to sit down and begins unbuttoning his vest. And then I blush scarlet and think, every god in the world for the darkness surrounding us. I'm not cold and I'm not bleeding, I say to him. Keep your clothes on. The boy looks at me. I would have expected his bright eyes to look dimmer in the night, but instead they seem to reflect the light coming from the windows above us. He's amused. Oh my gosh. Who said anything about you, sweetheart? Just the sweetheart? Okay. I would be fangirling over him and being like, oh my gosh, he's actually really cool. If his name wasn't Day, what is that? Like that's such a lame character name. Just saying.
Also, I'm getting really big Thorn vibes. Don't ask. I just am. And like, what's the, like, is it Zoe? I don't know, but like, he reminds me a lot of Thorn. But then, I didn't know he had a limp. It literally just goes, he realizes that I noticed his limp. What is he, Casbreaker?
Guys, it's like the wound bandage trope. I love this trope
so much. I'm so excited. I just got to, we should change those bandages. I'm not as good as she is, but I'd rather not wake her up.
I wonder what's about to happen.
Guys, on page 134, I made a doodle. Put the quote, but every now and then, when I still glance at the girl or feel her eyes on me, I helplessly drift back to thinking about her. I'm loving this series so far. I literally am so glad I decided to read this so spontaneously. Good job, me.
I died, guys. I died. I literally just died.
I'm gone. I just got to the part where they kissed.
And he goes, sorry, he murmurs. He gives me a look laced with mischief. I couldn't help it. But at least now it's over with.
This is why I love young adult, though, because I know this is the farthest it'll get, and this is cute, fluffy stuff. I live for this crap. This is so good. It's so funny. I'm, like, not a fan of romance. Like, I hate romance. I'm like, barf. See romance in real life? Barf. But in books, you can't see why I'm kicking my feet. Now I'm gonna make a little illustration of me dying. I feel like I spend more time illustrating the book than I do reading it sometimes. It's fun though. I highly recommend.
Guys, I'm gonna be like obsessed with this for the next month. This book is so good. I'm on page 155. I trusted this girl. Had been duped into kissing her, even falling for her. The thought makes me blind with rage.
Drama, 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 drama. I love it. I seriously love enemies to lovers. Sure, it's like an overused trope and it gets a little old, but if it's done well, like, this is really refreshing because I haven't read an enemies to lovers in a while. And I feel like that's how most people should, like, read books, is like you read a bunch of different stuff. Because, like, I'm not going to read all the Twilight books at once. No, that'll be maddening. Sorry, that's, like, the first thing I glanced at. So, like, read Twilight, like, one Twilight book, so it's, like, vampires and, like, just a love story, and then go to something that's high fantasy with not much of a love story, like the Maze Runner. And then go to something like a romance, and then go to something like a classic, and then go to something that's really high fantasy kind of thing. Like, that's, I feel like that's how I not get out of, how I don't get burned out of reading is I just like switch up my genre, and reading classics does really help.
Okay, so on page 158, I'm gonna take a little break, get some things done. This is so good so far. Like, I'm so glad I've started reading this.
I've never had a negative reading blog. Actually, I did have a negative reading blog. I never finished the book. I'm not gonna say what book it is. So the reading blog just never got posted, but yeah, this one is so good. Like, I highly recommend this book now. It's so good. Just like, don't get high expectations though from me reading it. Cause yeah.
Hey everyone, happy Good Friday. It has been an extremely crazy, chaotic week. So I haven't read anything. So today I'm going to finish Legendborn.
Legend? Not Legendborn.
Wrong book. I'm gonna finish Legend. I'm like halfway, past the bookmark. like a little over half, I'm like 70%. So I'm just gonna knock it out and then see how much I can read of Prodigy. But yeah, so sorry about that.
I just finished the book. Lana, say hi.
Here's my sister.
It was really good. I'd rate it 3.5, 4 stars
out of 5 stars.
Definitely for ages 12 and older.
So I'd been holding it in while my eyes kept from... Wow. I cannot read. Oh my gosh.
This girl. She'd been... Wow.